Hello, everyone. We're beginning our next panel. So if everyone can take a seat. So to begin, we are going to have Chief Ninawa from Acre, Brazil, open with a beautiful song from his territory. It's an honor to be with you today. And I'm so happy to see you again. So if you don't mind opening this panel with a song, we would be honored.
Hey, 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 he, 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 he. Shaka pinga ping, shaka pinga ping, pum abi monoi, mono inakirawu, umbaka joi matang, shinan watapai, pubu wakaya. Haira 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 haira. Ang shaka pinka ping, ang shaka pinka ping, pung abi mono I nakirawu, umbaka joi matang, shinan watapai, pubuakaya. Haira 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 Yo bayus kunawana, yo bayus kunawana, yo bayus kumarabi mi pu putua pa shabatani mu pu buakaya. Haira 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 Ukunai ukua ukunai ukua ukunai marabi mi puputua pushabatani mu pushabatani mu pubuakaya. Haira 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 Juan Caro Yoshibu, Mishinam Pupá Biranquim, Mishinam Xobaco Biranquim, Meu Xupachinam Pupá Biranquim, Mimboyen Biranquim, Jeu Xancuru, Xuaquim, Minauan, Ush. Aos.
Obrigado. Thank you so much. That was beautiful. We were in the Yucatan together for 2 weeks with Monica, who will be translating. So nice to see you again, Monica. So,
So Monica is going to be translating en español, perdón. Monica va a estar traduciendo todo en portugués y yo en español.
So this beautiful panel. Thank you everyone for joining, and thank you Doma for joining last minute as well. We're here to talk about the significance of sacred sites and sacred elements and biocultural heritage. So I wanted to start out by everyone introducing yourself and where you come from.
Mi nombre es Mindaji Bastida, del pueblo Otomí Tolteca del centro de México. Y vengo aquí como representante vocero del Consejo del Águila y el Cóndor, pero también delegado de la Madre Tierra y miembro de la Alianza de Guardianes de la Madre Naturaleza.
So, ¿Su nombre es?
Okay, my name is Mindaji Bastida from the Otomi Toltec peoples from Central Mexico. I'm representing here the Mother Earth delegation, the Grand Council of the Eagle and the Condor, and also member, the executive member of the Alliance Guardians of Mother Nature.
Thank you. Hi, my name is Doma Clark, and I'm originally from Siberian Russia, from Lake Baikal. Lake Baikal is the deepest a sacred lake in the world, one of the oldest lakes in the world, contains 20% of the fresh world water and has a unique biohabitat. And I'm extremely honored to be here, and I'm very sad at the same time, because there is no delegation and I'm not in any formal capacity representing my community. It just happened to be like I was born and raised there, and then I saw there is nobody here representing that area, and that with support of the friends and family, I'm here today with you on this panel, and thank you very much, Julia.
So can we go by step by step, by name and a little bit slower, that way I can translate? Dolma, ella es Dolma de Siberia, del lago Walcat.
Maybe you can just translate. It's one of the sacred, deepest, oldest lakes in the world.
Es uno de los lagos más sagrados del mundo.
I am Helen Lindmark. Madaraka, great-grandmother, comes from the north of Sweden, from Sápmi.
Ella viene de Sweden, y su nombre es Ellen.
And I'm a part of the Mother Earth delegation.
Es parte de la delegación de la Madre Tierra.
And I'm here to... I'm walking with the... with the voice of Mother Earth, and I think it's important that we come from all direction as an indigenous and help each other.
Viene aquí representando y escuchando la voz de la Madre Tierra, y es importante que la escuchemos y que sepamos dónde ella nos va a direccionar.
It's important that the message comes out, that the voice has been heard.
Es importante que el mensaje no solo se escuche, pero que también se reparta.
Thank you.
Gracias.
I'm Julia Jackson. I'm honored to be a co-host of this gathering today. I founded a non-profit, grounded.org.
Mi nombre es Julia, y estoy honrada de ser partícipe, y... soy una fundadora de una organización sin ánimos de lucros.
And I've learned a lot from my dear friend Mindahi Bastida here on stage.
Y he aprendido mucho de mi gran amigo Mandija aquí, que nos acompaña en el escenario.
To be more in the heart.
Para estar más presente a través del corazón.
And the importance of sacred sites all around the world.
Y la importancia de
sacred sites and territories.
De los territorios sagrados.
Thank you.
Gracias.
Muito boa tarde a todas e todos.
Good afternoon to everyone.
Quero aqui, na presença da nossa avó, Francisca Calfin.
Grandmother, como que é o nome?
Francisca Calfin. Cumprimentar a todos que estão aqui presente e também aqui na mesa.
I want to congratulate everyone who is here present. Sorry for not using the mic.
Quero agradecer muito pelo convite.
I want to thank you very much for the invitation.
Em nome do meu povo, para mim é uma honra poder estar aqui.
In behalf of my people for allowing me to be here.
O meu nome é Ninawa.
My name is Ninawa.
Eu sou Runikui.
I am Runikui.
Sou do estado do Acre, da região amazônica do Brasil.
I'm from the state of Acre in the area of the Amazon in Brazil.
E faço parte do grande conselho de Águia e Condor.
I'm part of the Eagle and Condor Council.
E também há mais de 20 anos eu venho lutando pela vida do nosso planeta.
I have been fighting for the life of our planet for 20 years.
Eu sou cacique geral do meu povo.
I am leader of our people.
Bom,
tem muitas
funções, mas vou... os principais são esses.
So, maybe that was a little much, but he's He helps people.
E agradecer a Júlia, ao mesmo tempo que parabenizo por organizar esses momentos que são muito importantes.
He wants to thank Julia for organizing these moments, which are very important.
E espero aqui poder contribuir a contento desse evento e da pauta.
I hope that I'll be able to contribute content to this meeting, this panel.
Estou aqui à disposição. Obrigado.
I'm here at your disposition.
Thank you. So I'm going to begin asking everyone before we get into biocultural heritage and sacred sites, what does it mean for you to be grounded? So I'm going to start with Mindahi. First translate. Thank you.
Bueno, voy a empezar el panel preguntando qué significa para ti estar en contacto con la naturaleza.
Connected grounded to the earth.
Sí.
Grounded, rooted.
Sí, estar con la naturaleza.
So if everyone can answer, just for the sake of time, I'm not going to answer.
Thank you for this question. I might take the whole night explaining to you what. But really to get connected, I'm connected ever since I was a little one. And I don't want to lose that connection. To be connected is to have the spirit, mind, and body in eternal interrelationship with the sacred, with mystery. We don't want to understand mystery. We live in mystery.
Thank you. So, for me, oh,
can we translate?
Sí, lo voy a traducir. Que esa pregunta es una pregunta pues muy profunda, es una pregunta que nos puede llevar toda la noche a mí platicarlo. Pero en resumen solo es que desde pequeño me he sentido conectado. No he perdido ese linaje y no quiero perderlo. Y para mí esa conexión es tan sagrada que pues me da la oportunidad de estar aquí en este tiempo y espacio. Y esa conexión es la que me mantiene vivo y me mantiene conectado en todo momento.
From my point of view, staying grounded, we can take it start off from a literal sense, be connected to the earth under your feet. And I heard a beautiful, beautiful interview from artist Anthony Gormley, it's a British artist, and he said, if you want to change the world, start with yourself. And the first, the most simple thing you can do is take your shoes off and feel the ground. Your feet is the most unrepresented organ of your body, but then it's directly connected to the ground. If we're not feeling it, like how we're going to connect to it? The second component, or maybe we translate it here, or it's too much.
Dice que para ella lo que significa estar en contacto con la tierra. Pues una vez escuché una entrevista donde la persona dijo, lo primero que hay que hacer es quitarse los zapatos, poner nuestros pies en la tierra, porque es la única manera en la que puedes sentir la energía de la madre tierra.
And the second component to that is reconnection and connect to yourself and stay centered and be grounded, because in our traditional culture is all about understanding oneself. And only when you're well and connected to yourself, only then you can start caring about your family, children. You need to be well and healthy physically and mentally to be able to care about your community and environment around us. So health of your own human health is directly interlinked with the health of the planet.
La segunda parte que me deja estar conectada con la madre tierra es estar conectada conmigo misma y cultivar esa relación con uno mismo, porque si uno no está sano, no puede cuidar a la comunidad y no puede cuidar más allá.
For me to be grounded is to be centered on solid to be home in myself. And as my sister said, I see it as a symbol of a tree, that my feet are my roots. My life is, the stem is my body. And the connection I have to the universe, to the sky, is the branches, it's growing. And it's to be totally connected. But we need first to come home to ourselves. We need to embrace ourselves. We all have a journey in life, and we are all unique. And we cannot change the past, but we can do something now. We can create new rings on the water by being solid, grounded, and listen to our heart and listen to our inner voice.
Thank you.
Dice que ella, para ella lo que significa pues estar en conexión con la Madre Tierra, se imagina que ella es como un árbol, que sus pies son las raíces, que el tronco es su cuerpo y que las hojas son su conexión con el universo. Y que pues sí, hay muchas cosas que han pasado malas en el pasado, pero ahora estamos en un momento presente y podemos crear nuevas ondas en el agua. Y esas ondas nuevas pueden ser creadas cuando estamos con conexión con la Madre Tierra.
No Brasil existe un ditado popular.
In Brazil, there's a popular story.
Que é realmente essa pergunta, que é, a gente tem que ter pé no chão.
That it's a saying that says you really have to keep your feet on the ground.
En Brasil hay una historia muy importante que dice que tenemos que poner nuestros pies en la tierra.
E essa expressão, pé no chão, significa ter humildade.
This expression, to have your feet on the ground, it means to be humble.
Essa expressão de tener nuestros pies en la tierra significa ser humilde.
Ter simplicidade.
To be simple, to live in simplicity.
Ter o respeito.
Have respect.
E isso faz com que as pessoas possam ter uma harmonia.
And this allows people to live in harmony.
De vivir en simplicidad, vivir con respeto, y esto es lo que nos deja vivir en armonía.
E essa palavra, ela é muito importante.
And this word is very important.
É o que nós precisamos ter, o pé no chão.
That we need to have our feet on the ground.
Não importa a nossa classe social.
It doesn't matter what part of society we come from.
Não importa a divisão geográfica que nós vivemos.
It doesn't matter which part of the country we come from, where we live.
Todos nós seguimos o mesmo cordão umbilical.
We all have the same umbilical cord.
Y esa palabra es muy importante porque no importa de dónde vienes, no importa cuál es tu estado socioeconómico, no importa dónde vives, lo que importa es que todos estamos unidos con un cordón umbilical que va entre todos nosotros.
Y ese cordón umbilical,
and this umbilical cord,
eles nos levará novamente de encontro com a nossa Mãe Terra. Vai nos levar todos nós de encontro à Mãe Terra.
And this will take us all back to Mother Earth. It connects us with Mother Earth.
Então isso é muito importante, essa palavra. So this importante is... termos o pé no chão, humildade.
So this is very important to keep our feet on the ground, to be grounded, to have humility.
E este cordón umbilical nos une con la Madre Tierra, y por eso es muy importante que tengamos nuestros pies en la tierra, para mantener esa conexión.
Thank you. So let's talk about sacred sites, sacred territories.
Mindahi, you've taught me a lot about the significance of all these beautiful sacred sites and the prophecies that tell us we have to keep them, we have to honor them before a certain time period. And I wanted to ask each and every one of you, from your origin, from your country, is there a sacred site that means something to you? And what do sacred sites mean to you? So if we can start with you, Mindahi.
Quiero hacer una pregunta sobre lugares sagrados y Mindahi me ha enseñado mucho sobre la importancia de lugares sagrados y la pregunta es, ¿cuál es un lugar sagrado en sus comunidades y qué significa para ustedes?
And a lot of people watching, I understand what a sacred site is, but can you also explain in your words what a sacred site means?
Yes. Thank you for this, because it's very important in our lives to acknowledge the sacred. Because for the beginning, we understand that we are in a time and a space here at this moment.
Es muy importante que nuestras vidas podamos reconocer lo que es sagrado.
Y lo sagrado, los sitios sagrados o los lugares sagrados en el mundo son el reflejo de los lugares sagrados en nuestro cuerpo.
And the sacred sites around the world are actually a reflection of the sacred sites in our bodies.
El Amazonas y el Congo son los pulmones del mundo.
The Amazon and the Congo are the lungs of the planet.
El corazón de la tierra está en la Sierra Nevada de Santa Marta.
The heart of the earth is in the Sierra Nevada de Santa Marta.
The umbilical cord is in Mexico.
The umbilical cord, el cordón umbilical está en México.
Y así podemos nombrar otros sitios sagrados.
And that's how we can name different sacred sites.
Todas las montañas, todos los volcanes son sagrados.
Every single mountain, every single volcano is sacred.
¿Pero qué es un sitio sagrado?
But what is a sacred site?
Porque tiene una energía especial, una energía que está dando vida, da aire, da calor, da naturaleza, da producción, da todo lo que podemos sentir. Cuando llegamos a un sitio sagrado, sentimos una cosa especial.
Sacred sites are places that have a lot of energy. They give life, they give air, they give warmth. And when you arrive to a sacred site, you can feel that energy.
Yendo a los sitios sagrados me he encontrado algo. En algunos sitios sagrados, cuando llegamos, tenemos que pedir permiso, especial permiso, y pagar algo, ofrendar.
When I go to sacred sites, it's very important to ask for permission to go there. And when you arrive, you have to give something as an offering.
He visto que en algunos sitios sagrados, en muchos, hay mariposas.
I have noticed that in a lot of sacred sites, there are butterflies.
Y si ustedes pueden sentir, cuando llegan allí, sienten algo distinto, sienten como volver al vientre de la madre tierra.
And if you notice your feelings when you go there, you have this feeling of returning to Mother Earth.
Sienten amor.
You feel love.
Pero hay que tener cuidado al ir a un sitio sagrado.
But one has to be careful when going to a sacred site.
You cannot play with sacred sites because they are very important for Mother Earth and for us, for life.
No podemos jugar en sitios sagrados porque son muy importantes para nosotros y para la Madre Tierra.
They represent the four sacred elements.
Representan los cuatro elementos sagrados.
Via cave, via an island, via valley, top of the mountain, via wetland.
Puede ser una cueva, puede ser una montaña, una isla. y un
humedal.
Un humedal.
Hay muchos sitios sagrados en el mundo, muchos.
There's a lot of sacred sites around the world.
Pero hay unos más importantes.
But there are some that are more important.
Quiero reconocer aquí algunos sitios sagrados, por ejemplo, Uluru. Uluru en Australia.
I want to recognize a very important sacred site here, which is Uluru in Australia.
Mount Fuji in Japan. Mount Fuji in Japan.
Mount Fuji in Japan.
Mount Etna in Sicily, Italia.
Etna in Italia, in Sicily.
The Andes.
Los Andes.
Kilimanjaro. The Kilimanjaro volcano. The Kilimanjaro mountain in Africa. Kilimanjaro in Africa. But I also want to bring the attention of the beautiful volcanoes that we have in Mexico. The Popocatépetl and Iztaccíhuatl.
También quiero hablar sobre los volcanes que tenemos en México, el Popocatépetl y la Iztaccíhuatl.
But you have in your hearts your sacred sites as well.
Y ustedes en sus corazones tienen lugares sagrados también.
¿Qué pasa si les quitan su corazón a ustedes?
What would happen if they took your heart away from you?
You die, right?
Te morirías.
That's the reason we have to protect sacred sites. The major sacred sites in the world, we need to protect them. And we are doing this for millennia.
Y es por eso que tenemos que proteger a los lugares sagrados del mundo. Y hemos estado haciendo esto por miles de años.
Pero ahora están amenazados.
But now they're being threatened.
Por la minería.
Because of mines.
Por la bioprospección. Biopiracy.
Biopiracy.
Están amenazados por la deforestación.
They're being threatened with deforestation.
Por los incendios.
Wildfires.
Por las inundaciones.
Flooding.
Y por todos aquellos que buscan el lucro.
And by all of those that are looking for profit.
Bueno, quiero decirles solamente, mi vida ha sido alrededor de los sitios sagrados, pero solamente quiero decirles que nuestro amor por los lugares sagrados debe estar unido siempre, de que nacemos hasta que morimos.
I have lived through a lot across my life, and I just want to say that the love for sacred sites has to be present from when we are born till we die.
Necesitamos protegerlos legalmente.
We have to protect them legally.
Porque están en peligro, y nuestra vida también. Y la vida de todos los seres.
Because they are in danger, and so are we, and the life of all beings.
Thank you.
Gracias.
I was thinking to focus only on one sacred site, but I'm going to mention two today. Since I come from one of the deepest, oldest lakes in the world,
hoy voy a hablar sobre dos lugares sagrados. El primero es uno. Yo vengo de uno de los lagos más hondos del mundo.
And since Mindahi said about protection of the ecology, since it's all a massive sacred site, I was thinking about, okay, let's start there. In our community, everything is sacred. So we believe that everything that's alive, and even a stone, has its own life cycle and its own spirit, so to say. So actually, everything is sacred, what you see around you. It's all part of you, and at the end of the day, your biology and body is part of this universe. So everything is sacred.
Para empezar, quiero decir que todo es sagrado. Las rocas son sagradas, tienen su ciclo de vida. Nosotros somos sagrados porque estamos en esta tierra.
So when we talk about this special sacred site that contains sort of the heart of the ecosystem, so to say.
Entonces, cuando hablamos de lugares sagrados especiales, lugares que tienen el corazón de nuestros ecosistemas.
It's similar to what we say keystone species, but these are like not alive animals, but like water and mountains, etc. And in our case, it's Lake Baikal.
Es como, por ejemplo, darle respeto a cosas como el agua, que tiene su propio espíritu.
So this lake is, when I was growing up, when you swim, you could drink that water, and you can't see the end of the lake because it's so big. And it contains 1,800 endemic species that only live in this little region.
En mi lago era, pues yo podía tomar el agua cuando era más chica, y es tan grande que no puedes ver el final, y tiene más de 1,800 especies endémicas.
So, and now I'm 30, and during my lifetime, there were two big crises, and one is still going on. One, when I was around 10 years old, that the government wanted to build, and actually did, but then we managed to close it down, a paper factory. So there was no respect neither to the local communities, neither to the environment. And there was a big crisis that we managed to stop. But there is
En mi vida han habido dos crisis. La primera es que el gobierno quiso construir una fábrica de papel en el lago.
But this factory was closed, and the doors are sealed, but inside there are all these toxic barrels inside, and at any given point it might leak.
Y esta fábrica ahorita está cerrada, pero adentro sigue teniendo barriles con químicos que en cualquier momento se podrían salir.
So the battle continues. The second big crisis is the toxic algae blooms. So since the industrial agriculture, we've always been self-subsistent farmers, and we never used any chemicals. But you know, with capitalism coming to this region, with industrial agriculture, the chemical runoffs from the rivers, they all end up in the lake, now causing the toxic, harmful algae blooms that basically kills all the biodiversity of the lake. And then, as I mentioned earlier, when I was growing up, we would drink water from the lake, no problem, and now we can't do that anymore.
La segunda crisis son los brotamientos de alga, y esta alga viene porque hay muchos químicos en el lago y ya no podemos tomar el agua del lago, y esa alga mata la biodiversidad del lago.
So there is big job that needs to be done there, and it's directly also perhaps related to culture, and our culture is listed as UNESCO endangered culture list, and the language is disappearing. I was the last generation growing up that was taught in a native language.
Y el problema que tenemos es la pérdida de cultura. La UNESCO dice que mi pueblo está básicamente desapareciendo y la lengua está desapareciendo, y yo fui de la última generación que todavía habló la lengua.
And talking about the second piece on sacred sites, it's related to the ancestral line.
Y para hablar sobre los lugares sagrados, están relacionados con tierra ancestral.
So we keep an oral record, it's actually not written, oral record of where our ancestors come from, and we have for our family, we have like a stone in the middle of the steps, and we go there every year to pay respect to our ancestors. And that's very specific to each family and where your ancestors come from. So recognizing that and reconnecting back to your roots is also a very big spiritual sort of message.
Y también tenemos una roca donde tenemos todos los ancestros que hemos tenido, entonces vamos y le damos gracias a esos ancestros, y la mayoría de nuestra historia es historia oral, y cada familia tiene algo diferente en cómo conectarse pues a los ancestros. Gracias.
I come from a part of the world where we have a lot of sacred sites, and for us the sacred site is where the ancestral wisdom is stored, but they are also the protector of us,
there are mountains that carry a wisdom and a protection. So when the mining comes or other industrial, it also shows how the community starts to get sick in different way.
Yo vengo de una región donde hay muchos lugares sagrados y estos lugares sagrados tienen mucha sabiduría. Y no solamente tienen sabiduría, pero también nos protegen. Entonces, cuando vienen proyectos como proyectos de minería, nos terminan hiriendo a la comunidad.
It's been there for 1,000 years and every ancestor that walked there had put their energy of protection for their people. And that's so important. What I can see is also that we need also really listen beyond everything. We need to go inside and listen. What is she telling us when we enter a new land? What is the mountain? What is the vibration? What is the frequency of it?
Cuando vamos a un lugar nuevo, tenemos que preguntarnos qué nos está diciendo la madre tierra, cuál es su vibración, cuál es el espíritu, cuál es el mensaje que nos está dando.
We are still lucky, so we have water in the mountains we directly can drink. That's how we survived generations back. We lived in the nature because we are the nature.
Hay muchas generaciones que han estado viviendo de estas aguas limpias y nosotros vivimos de la naturaleza porque somos naturaleza.
That's why it's so important to protect all the sacred sites all over the world, to keep Mother Earth healthy, to keep her with love and humbleness and really care for her, because she is here for us 24 hours a day. Thank you.
Y por eso es importante que protejamos a la Madre Tierra, porque la Madre Tierra nos protege a nosotros. Y es importante que pues absorbamos esa humildad y esa humildad y que pues sí protejamos a lo que nos da vida.
Thank you, Grandmother Helen. That was beautiful.
Mais uma boa pergunta.
Another good question.
E os anciãos do meu povo sempre nos ensinaram que um lugar sagrado é a casa, são casa dos espíritos.
Where I come from, we are told that it's historic. O que é casa dos espíritos?
O sítio sagrado para nós representa a casa dos espíritos.
The house, the sacred sites are where the spirits live.
Tem uma música que fala da criação do mundo na história do meu povo.
There's a music that talks about the creation of the world.
Fala de Ubumana Murani. Fala a grande casa do espírito.
It talks about the big house of the spirit.
De donde yo vengo, me enseñaron que los lugares sagrados son la casa de los espíritus y hay una canción muy hermosa que habla sobre estos sitios sagrados, pues siendo espacios para los espíritus.
Yububumarani es el planeta.
Yububumarani es el planeta.
Y en este planeta existe muitos espíritos.
In this planet there are a lot of spirits who live.
Nosso território do nosso povo.
The land of our people.
En este planeta hay muchos espíritus. Esta tierra es la tierra de nuestra gente.
No território do nosso povo existe lugares que são muito especial espiritualmente para nós.
Okay, in the land of our people, where our people live, there are many areas that are very special for us, that are sacred sites.
En la tierra de nuestros pueblos, hay lugares que son sagrados para nuestra gente, son muy especiales.
Bom, dentro do nosso território tem várias milhares de espécies de plantas medicinais. Mas cada planta medicinal tem o seu lugar certo aonde ela vive.
So within our territory there are millions of species of plants and each one has its own special place where it lives and functions.
En nuestro territorio hay miles de plantas y plantas medicinales que cada una de ellas tiene su propio territorio.
E esses espaços onde essas plantas medicinais são, elas são espaços sagrados para nós.
So these places where these medicinal, these sacred plants live, these places are very sacred for us.
And the spaces where these medicinal plants are very special to us.
You Spanish.
Y este lugar donde están estas plantas sagradas son muy especiales para nosotros.
Son lugares aonde só pessoas de conhecimento das medicinas podem ir.
There are places where only people with knowledge of these plants can go.
Son lugares donde solamente la gente que tiene conocimiento sobre estas plantas puede ir.
Un río que pasa dentro de nuestro territorio, él es muy sagrado para nosotros.
A river that passes through the territory where we live is very sacred for us.
Existe una ceremonia antigua de mi pueblo.
There's a very old sacred ceremony of my people.
Hay un río que pasa por nuestra tierra que es muy sagrado para nosotros y hay una ceremonia que es muy importante para nuestro pueblo.
Y esta ceremonia se hacía en las nacientes de los ríos.
So this ceremony takes place at the source of the rivers.
Então quem fazia essa cerimônia vivia mais de 100 anos.
So the person who would perform these ceremonies would live for more than 100 years.
E a minha avó que hoje tem 134 anos.
My grandmother, who's now 130 years old,
ela fez essa cerimônia.
She performed this ceremony.
Esta ceremonia es muy importante porque pasa donde brota el agua y las personas que hacen esta ceremonia viven más de 100 años. Mi abuela tiene 130 años y ha hecho esta ceremonia por toda su vida.
E essas nascentes desses rios, eles são espaço sagrado para o nosso povo.
The source of these rivers, these are very sacred sites for our people.
E nesses espaços sagrados, as pessoas do meu povo não vão lá só colher medicina ou só fazer a cerimônia para receber as bênçãos.
Okay. So this in the source of the river, our people can go and collect medicines and get water and perform ceremonies.
Donde brota el agua, la gente puede ir a recoger medicina, puede ir a hacer ceremonia.
Y então isso para nós, por isso que nós dizemos, espaço sagrado no nosso povo são casa dos espíritos.
So this is why we say that sacred sites for us are the houses of the spirits.
E esses espaços sagrados, eles são responsáveis pelo equilíbrio espiritual, de harmonia entre nós.
So these sacred places, we consider, we need to take responsibility. They're very important and we need to remain in harmony and have a lot of respect for them.
Estos lugares sagrados, esta es la razón por la que estos lugares sagrados son muy importantes para nosotros y es por eso que tenemos que vivir en armonía con estos lugares.
Fiquei un poco triste.
I was a little sad
cuando nós fomos. Eu fui na terra do meu irmão Mindahi, no México.
When we went to the land of my brother Mindahi, which is in Mexico.
E quando nós estávamos na comissão para levar alimento espiritual naqueles sítios sagrados que dali daquele território.
So we were there to make sacred offerings in this sacred place, and we were bringing offerings.
E as pessoas não nos permitiam entrar dentro desse espaço.
And the people in charge did not allow us to enter in this sacred space.
Algo muy triste que pasó en el territorio de mi hermano Mindaji fue que fuimos y no nos dejaron entrar con las ofrendas que traíamos.
Y eso fez con que pudesse ficar vários dias fazendo uma reflexão de que nós temos que libertar esses espaços do sistema de governo e devolver esses espaços às espiritualidades.
So we spent a lot of time reflecting on this situation and realizing that we needed to free these sacred spaces from the control of the government and return them to being sacred places.
Nos dimos cuenta que tenemos que no podemos dejar que el gobierno tenga control de estos lugares sagrados y que tenemos que recuperar el control de para poder proteger a esos lugares sagrados.
Es muy importante.
It's very important.
Para nós, os nossos elementos espiritual. E hoje a gente vê muito em museu. O museu não é um espaço para nós guardar nossos elementos sagrados. Eles têm que ser livres.
There, now I'm thinking of our sacred elements. There are museums in the world that have many of our sacred objects. And these objects aren't meant to be in museums. They're meant to be free.
Hay muchos lugares, muchos museos en el mundo que tienen nuestros objetos sagrados y estos objetos no deberían estar en museos, deberían estar con nosotros.
Então queria dizer isso e dizer que os espaços sagrados não são lugares somente para a gente ir colher boas energias, mas a gente tem que também espiritualmente alimentar esses espaços sagrados.
So I also wanted to say that these sacred sites aren't just for people to go and receive good energy, good vibrations from, but it's also important for us to go and feed these places.
Estos lugares sagrados no solamente son para que la gente vaya y reciba la energía de los lugares sagrados, pero también es importante dar y dar ofrendas a la tierra.
Thank you so much. I was there with you and Monica too and Mindaji when we got turned away.
Wanka.
Estábamos ahí, yo estaba ahí cuando nos dijeron que no podíamos entrar a este lugar sagrado.
Yes, and it was very heartbreaking in a lot of ways.
Fue muy doloroso en muchos sentidos.
But we felt so connected as one.
Pero nos sentíamos conectados de todas maneras. Los unos a los otros.
And you all didn't give up.
Y ustedes no se rindieron.
And your hearts were still beating.
Y sus corazones seguían latiendo.
The beat of Mother Earth.
El latido de la Madre Tierra.
Thank you.
Gracias.
So I want to be conscious of time. I noticed Calphine came in. They're going to do a closing ceremony in a few minutes with Minga Indigena. But I still have one more question to ask the panel. Let's talk about, and maybe in just a few sentences, sacred elements. Because right now we're gathered with fire. Water. There's so many different sacred elements of the planet.
Quiero estar consciente del tiempo y por eso nada más va a haber una pregunta más. Quiero hacer una reflexión sobre elementos sagrados, porque ahorita estamos reunidos con agua y fuego.
And I recognize that all elements are sacred.
Y reconozco que todos los elementos son sagrados.
But I would be curious to hear from each of you what element might speak to you.
Pero quiero saber de cada uno de ustedes cuál es el elemento que les habla.
For me, it is fire.
Para mí es el fuego.
I lost my home to the Kincaid fire.
Yo perdí mi casa con uno de los incendios en California.
And I could have lost my life.
Y pude haber perdido mi vida.
And the only object I grabbed out of my home.
Y la única, el único objeto que traje conmigo.
Was actually an Otomi Toltec necklace.
Fue un collar Otomi que mi papá le dio.
From Mindahi, that was a water god.
Era un dios de agua.
And that element protected me during a really big fire. So for me, fire represents, while it represents destruction and we're in the age of fire, it also represents purification, renewal, regeneration, and healing. So while I'm scared of fire, I also honor how important it is as an element of life.
Para mí el fuego, pues sí tiene esa connotación de peligro por cómo quemó mi casa, pero también reconozco que tiene poderes de purificación y que estamos en un proceso de purificación. Entonces por eso respeto al fuego.
So for me it's fire, but I'd like to close. Of course I had a few more questions, but why don't we close with each of you talking about an element that really speaks to you and why?
Yes.
Vamos a hablar de un elemento que sea importante para ustedes.
Yes, for me it's the wind.
Para mí es el viento.
I'm connected with the four sacred elements, the fire, the earth, the wind and the earth, but especially the wind.
Estoy conectado con los cuatro elementos, el fuego, la tierra, el aire y el agua, pero especialmente el aire.
And I gained my name, Mindahi, because when I was three months old, I died.
Y mi nombre es Mindahi, lo gané porque cuando yo tenía 3 años, yo morí.
And it was the wind that gave me back life.
Y fue el viento que me regresó a la vida.
My mom says that she was screaming and then she put me her hands like that and a big wind came and gave me back the life.
Mi mamá dice que cuando yo era pequeño y esto me pasó, me puso en el cielo y un viento vino y me regresó a la vida.
In a sacred ceremony, I received my name.
Yo recibí mi nombre en una ceremonia sagrada.
In the Otomi Ceremonial Center.
En el centro ceremonial Otomi.
By the elders.
Por los abuelos.
My name means the Lord of the Wind.
Mi nombre significa el Señor del Viento.
Thank you.
Gracias.
I would like to pick up on the fire conversation since we're sitting in front of the fire. I've been home for the first time in 4 years this summer, this August, and I end up in the middle of the Siberian forest fires. This summer, it's estimated 20 million hectares of the Siberian forest was gone. And it's happening year on year, earlier and earlier, and bigger land getting destroyed, I suppose.
Yo también quisiera hablar sobre el fuego porque Este verano fui a regresar a mi casa por la primera vez en 4 años y me encontré en el medio de los fuegos en Siberia. Y cada año está pasando más, más temprano y cada vez más grande.
But at the same time, fire gave me life. As you know, in Siberia it gets really cold. And when I was a child, and actually building up on your story, I went outside and got locked up and I couldn't open the door. And I was probably around 5 years old. And it was like minus 30 outside. And I kind of froze into almost hibernation. And then when my parents found me, they obviously had to heat me up. And I believe that the fire gave me second life, similar to Mintai's story. And it's kind of very mystical, let's say, but yeah.
Cuando yo era pequeña, me pasó algo similar a la historia de Mindaji, porque en Siberia hace mucho frío. Entonces hubo un día en el que yo me quedé afuera y no pude abrir la puerta de mi casa y las temperaturas eran de menos 30 grados. Entonces mis papás me encontraron y el fuego fue el que me regresó a la vida.
So the story is that there is a fear and respect at the same time to this powerful element. And I would like to close with a quick legend. We've got a legend of the fire dragon.
Entonces, este elemento es muy importante para mí. Quisiera compartirles la historia del dragón de fuego.
So the fire dragon was assigned when the universe was created, chose this area to use as a lair or the place to live. And it comes out once in a while to see if the people are looking after the land well. And it already, the dragon came out before, and it was upset that the community didn't look after the land well, and then they did a bigger sort of flooding and fire to show the people that there is you can't mess around with nature. And now we don't know when the dragon is going to come, but there is this, we have to have this tension and respect that nature, because at the end of the day, nature probably doesn't need us.
El dragón de fuego, pues la historia es que el dragón de fuego viene a revisar si la gente está cuidando a su tierra. Entonces, cuando la gente se está portando mal, el dragón viene. Y ahora no sabemos cuándo va a venir el dragón, pero sabemos que va a venir y que va a ser una enseñanza para las personas.
Thank you very much for having me today, and thank you very much for all the friends and family in the room.
Gracias a todos por estar aquí.
Fire is the element I work with, and that is the one that is very important for us, because we have 6 weeks of almost totally darkness. And that's very important, because it's the sun, it's the light. And it's a symbol that is very strong in our culture.
El fuego también es muy importante para mí, porque hay mucha oscuridad a veces donde yo vengo, y el fuego es esa luz, el fuego es el sol, el fuego es vida.
But what I recognize when I'm walking with the fire in my country and in Europe is that it's necessary, the teachings about the fire, that is an energy and we need to respect it.
Lo que yo quiero decir es que es muy importante que nos demos cuenta que el fuego nos trae enseñanzas y que tenemos que respetarlo.
Because sometimes we have, because of the climate, we cannot start a fire. But people do that anyway, and that makes that the fire, it goes in the root system, and then it starts these big forest fires.
Hay veces que el fuego no debería estar ahí, pero la gente lo empieza de todas maneras. Entonces eso daña a las raíces.
Every element is sacred, and fire is, I'm born with fire. Today I walk a lot with water,
because it's also about the balance between the female and the man, masculine energy, to bring it together and bridge it. And to bridge the young people and give the teachings about these elements, that is so important.
El fuego es muy importante y también el agua, y yo también trabajo mucho con agua porque es ese balance de lo masculino y lo femenino. Y es muy importante también que le enseñemos sobre los elementos a las generaciones que están haciendo.
Thank you for listening for me to me today. Thank you for inviting me.
Gracias por escucharme, gracias por invitarme.
Bom, rapidamente, para contribuir, nós falamos sempre de quatro elementos sagrados para a vida.
So quickly, since I know we're running out of time, I want to speak about the four. We always talk about the four elements that are necessary for life.
Eu sempre digo que existe quinto elemento, que é o elemento do invisível, o elemento da espiritualidade.
I always say there's a fifth element, which is the invisible, which is spirituality.
Para cerrar esto, quiero decir que siempre hablamos sobre los cuatro elementos que son muy importantes y yo también veo el quinto elemento que es invisible, que es el elemento de la espiritualidad.
Mas eu queria fazer uma referência ao elemento da água.
I also wanted to make a reference to water, the element of water.
Pela grande importância que ela tem para a existência de todas as espécies vivas do planeta.
For the great importance that this element has for the existence of everyone on the planet.
O nosso corpo tem mais de 70% de água.
Yeah, our bodies has 70% of water.
E o nosso planeta, quando deram um nome que chamaram de planeta Terra, poderiam ter chamado de planeta Água.
Yes, we've called our planet Earth, but we could have called it water.
Porque é o que representa o nosso planeta em sua maior quantidade, because, são as águas.
Yes, because waters are the greater part of this Earth.
También quiero hacer una mención especial al agua, porque es muy importante. Nosotros somos 70% agua, y al planeta Tierra le pusimos planeta Tierra, pero lo pudimos haber puesto planeta Agua, porque al final del día hay más agua que tierra.
Ouch, ouch.
Ouch. Thank you so much, everyone. I want to thank our translators, Xie and Monica. Thank you so much. If we had more time, I want you to ask you both questions. I wanted to thank Mindahi for being on the panel and honoring. The lineage of Otomi Toltec. Thank you for joining us. And Dolma, thank you so much for joining us. And from the Buryat people of Lake Baikal, we're really grateful to have you. And also thank you, Dolma. She's a partner of this space today with Vivo Barefoot. Very conscious shoes. Some are made out of algae. And she actually has graciously delivered shoes. We collected a lot of your shoe sizes for all the original nations peoples that are here today. So she is gifting all of you some shoes. So thank you so much.
Hello. Quiero darle las gracias al panel. Gracias a Mindahi por traer el conocimiento Otomí. Gracias a Dom, porque también es una de las organizaciones que está aquí, el Vivo Barefoot. Y de hecho va a haber zapatos para todas, pues todos los que nos están aquí y ya recolectaron sus tallas. Entonces, zapatos para todos, para los pueblos.
So thank you. And thank you, Grandmother Helen, for coming all the way from Sweden, representing the Sami lineage. So being from European soil and representing so beautifully your country and your people. Thank you so much for joining this panel.
Thank you.
And thank you, Chief Nanawa, from the Hunakui peoples in Acre, Brazil.
Gracias, Abuela Helen, por venir desde Suecia. Viajaste mucho para representar a tu gente y lo hiciste muy bien. Y gracias, Chief Nanawa.
From the Hunakui peoples.
Del pueblo Hunakui.
From Acre, Brazil.
De Brasil.
We thank you for being here on this panel. And so to close it out, Chief Nanawa would like to invite us for one last song. He's going to sing in front of the fire, honoring the fire. And I wanted to lastly thank all the communities tuning in right now that have lit fires around the world. Women's Earth Alliance, if you're tuning in, your community, Mother Earth delegation, Minga, all the peoples lighting fires, even non-Indigenous allies that are just lighting candles, to really hold the light and feed this fire here. So thank you for everyone tuning in on the live stream. So Chief Nanaw, if you could close out with your song in front of the fire, and then we'll segue into Minga's closing ceremony. Thank you.
Gracias por gracias por estar en el panel y Chief Nanawa va a cerrar con una canción y le queremos dar gracias a todos las organizaciones que están aquí y a todos los que apoyaron este evento.
Vamos convidar todo mundo, né, quem sentir vontade para participar.
So everyone who wants to participate, please feel free, join in.
Quero fazer canto.
I want to sing a song.
Que é canto de irmandade.
It's a song about humanity.
Que todos nós, esse canto diz que todos nós vivemos no mesmo planeta.
This song says that we all live on the same planet.
Nós respiramos o mesmo ar.
We breathe the same air.
Nós bebemos da mesma água.
We drink the same water.
E isso nos faz sermos parte desses elementos sagrados.
So this makes us a part of these holy sacred elements.
E nós, enquanto seres humanos, nós não somos diferentes dos outros seres vivos.
So we as human beings aren't any different from other living things.
Nós temos a mesma vida.
We have the same life.
A vida que está em nós é a vida que está numa árvore, que está no animal, que está no rio.
The life that's in animals, that's in trees, that's in the river, it's all the same.
Por isso que chai, na nossa língua, chai, são amigos.
So, in our language, chai means we're friends. In Spanish, where's... She? Uh-oh. She left?
She might be a little tired. Is there someone else that
puedo resumir em portunhol, porque creo que pode compreender, não? Sim. Estoy diciendo que todas la canción que voy a hacer es una canción de hermandad, porque nosotros vivimos en el mismo planeta, respiramos el mismo aire, bebemos de la misma agua, entonces tenemos la misma vida, y que ni uno de nosotros son diferentes de los otros seres vivos, de las plantas, de los animales, de los ríos. Entonces esta canción dice eso. Chai en mi idioma dice amigos, hermanos, ¿no? Então, esta canção é por isso, para que podamos cerrar este momento. E sempre eu digo que meu avô disse que...
My grandfather says that. I always say that my grandfather says.
Meu avô disse que nós temos duas partes para estar escutando, não? Tem duas, uma entrada, outra de saída.
So he says that we have two elements to hear with one, well, two... We have ears to one where information goes in and the other where it goes out.
Y las canciones como son un rezo, como un canciones, nosotros podemos escuchar en nuestro corazón y podemos guardar en nuestro espíritu.
So the songs also we can hear with our heart and we can keep it in our soul and spirit.
Entonces este pedido que yo puedo hacer a todos que puedan escuchar con su corazón. Si quiere, puede guardar en su espíritu.
So you can all listen with your heart and keep it in your spirit.
Haburun kun yubani Haburun kun yubani Yubani irakakan Haun chayin shani bu Haburun kun yubani Haburun kun yubani Yubani irakakan Yubani irakakan Ah, 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 Hiripaka piriri, hiripaka piriri, hiripaka piriri, hiripaka piriri. Haburun kun yubani, haburun kun yubani, yubani irakashun, yubani irakakan. Ah, 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 i, 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 i. Manchapo yoshibu. Manchapa yoshibu kampuru tatukan. Ah, 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 i, 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 i. Hiripaka piriri, hiripaka piriri, hiripaka piriri. Hiripaka piriri, haburun kun yubani, yubani irakakan, yubani irakashun. Ah, 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 ah. Muitíssimo obrigado, que nosso Paco Chipá, nosso grande espírito, possa continuar nos permitindo a viver.
Thank you very much, and may the great spirit allow us to continue living.
Que nos otros puedan seguir nuestro camino con las bendiciones del Gran Espíritu.
We may be allowed to continue on our path with the blessings of the Great Spirit.
Que nuestra salud no falte.
That we have health, that our health continues.
Que nuestro trabajo, nuestros proyectos sea siempre abençoado por nuestro Gran Espíritu.
That our words, our work, and our projects are all protected by the Great Spirit.
Y que cada uno de nosotros, al término de la copa, podemos regresar a su casa en paz, con tranquilidad, encontrar su familia sana, bien, y seguir la vida luchando porque la esperanza no se puede morir. Auge, auge.
And that each of us at the end of this cup may be allowed to return safely home to our families, that they may be safe, and that we all be allowed to continue with our work. Ouch. Ouch.
Aus, aus. Parente. Bueno, aquí estamos todos juntos en un círculo con el agua y el fuego. Un día más. Todos los días de nuestra vida. Que nunca nos falte. Es lo que nos alimenta. Somos todos familia.
Oh, here we are. I'm sorry, I wasn't paying attention. Well, this is the end. We're all united here with, does someone want to try, do the Spanish? Thank you.
Nuestro gran jefe líder, Kunikuni. Mindaji, tu trabajo y así todo el trabajo de todos los abuelos y las abuelas aquí es lo que nos motiva como Minga indígena a seguir empujando y somos punta de flecha para que todas estas cosas sucedan. Estamos haciendo juntos. Juntas, juntes todos. Siempre es tan fortalecedor encontrarnos, vernos, fortalecernos. Reconocernos. reconocer los caminos que todos ustedes, los líderes y las líderes, han hecho para que estas cosas sucedan.
To recognize all the paths and journeys taken of all the leaders that are here today, the paths that they had to take to get here.
Y también todos nuestros compañeros con que estamos organizando.
And gratitude for all of the co-organizers that are supporting make these events possible.
Son meses, ¿no?
It has been months.
Otras ciudades, reuniones, aquí juntos.
Other, we've been meeting in other cities and being in a new cities, in a new city coming all together.
Para que estos momentos ocurran.
So that these moments can happen.
Tenemos que aprovecharlos.
And we really, really need to enjoy these moments that
y llevarnos en el corazón esa semilla.
And take these moments as a seed in our hearts.
Es una semilla.
It is a seed.
Nuestras relaciones son una semilla que cultivamos.
And our relationships are a seed that need to be cultivated.
Reguémoslas con buena agua.
And let's please water them with good water.
Que ellas van a alimentar nuestro camino en el futuro.
Because these seeds are going to feed us in the future.
Tienen que quedar bien sembradas.
They need to be planted well.
Bien cuidadas.
And be well taken care of.
Somos todos familia.
We are all a family.
Canto enamorado de un pájaro. Desde lejos oigo. El canto enamorado de un pájaro. Y ese pájaro es mi abuelo. Es mi abuelo que canta y canta enamorado. Es mi abuelo que canta y canta enamorado. Canta, 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 canta. Águila. Águila, 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 águila. Ajida, 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 ajida. Desde lejos oigo el canto enamorado de un pájaro, y ese pájaro es mi abuela que canta y canta enamorada, es mi abuela que canta y canta enamorada. Canta, 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 canta.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Kelfin. Thank you to all the Minga here, all of our brothers and sisters that are united in our protection of the sacred and of all life and our beautiful Mother Earth.